The industrial sector is going through a massive transformation, much like many of the other industries like aerospace, healthcare, and automotive. Electrification, the mass use of data, sensors, real-time analysis, predictive performance, all of these things are coming together to create much more complexity. This use of AI, ML, and big data to help new technologies cobot, coexist, co-work, and co-collaborate with humans. Simulating first allows our customers to look into scenario build against variables that may or may not be understood well enough to put into a product, but need to understand how the product will perform in that situation. So they have a wide range of both environmental and human interaction in their product in others' complex systems that make scenario building and scenario testing in a virtual environment much more efficient and cost effective than having to take those same capabilities and test them physically. Ansys' solutions here are both single physics and multiphysics, but also methodologies that are agnostic to anyone's physics, anyone's tools and applications. Those methods that we produce allow our customers to bring in that environment of tools to optimize against a singular problem that they may have. A good example of that, you know, an elevator was a pretty simple thing. You know, 100 years ago, you'd walk into an elevator and somebody would push a shift and say, going up, and you had one trajectory and one mission. Today is a much more complex integrated system. It's optimizing energy use, it's optimizing travel and trip, optimizing the life cycle of the products and parts and components that make up its full maintenance and cycle operations. So the complexity in which our customers sell components and technology in this new system environment where everything's connected and we're optimizing on energy, we're optimizing both on time and total lifecycle performance is a complexity that all of our OEMs are having to manage. It's something where simulation, both at the component level and the system level, is having an enormous impact on their bottom line. You know, we have a company that produces water pumps and their product has improved in efficiency by 80% in the last decade. Water pumps today constitute 10% of the total electricity used on planet. So here's a company that if extrapolated across all the water pump companies, 80% savings would mean 8% reduction in electricity use on planet. Pretty significant. This company would put the entire weight of simulation as the solution to how they were able to get their product to that level of efficiency, at the same time becoming more reliable and more sustainable. 80% of that product's performance in a life cycle of carbon footprint is going to be determined in the design phase. So at Ansys, we believe that the complexity of software and hardware coming together is actually providing an opportunity for our customers to enhance their products, not just out the door, but over their full life cycle. By continuously upgrading their performance based upon feedback from the fleet or real-time feedback from the field with embedded sensors and the like, we believe our customers are going to continually be able to improve their performance, their cost position, their reliability, and ultimately serve their customers better with this insight. So the industrial engineering community really has three challenges as we look to the next decade in design. One, even simple or perceived to be simple subsystems are going to have to be integrated into much more complex systems. Those complexities are going to drive a level of uncertainty into the design because the scenarios in which their products may be used may be well beyond their expectation. Virtual testing at a larger scale of these complex systems is going to be absolutely necessary to save money, to improve the safety of their products and the durability and life cycle performance. And lastly, all of that comes under the umbrella of regulatory and or sustainable solutions, both in the use of materials, the use and cost, both in energy and in material of their product as it's constructed and manufactured and for its long life cycle application. So look, this is a really exciting time to be interfacing with our customers. And really, one of the things that excites me most is a level of collaboration that's now necessary That kind of collaboration with our channel partners, with our scientists, with our engineers and their engineers is creating solutions and answers to problems that frankly have never been solved before. These problems are not only exciting to solve, but they're worth the solution and the innovation of humanity.